Have you ever gazed up at the night sky, wondering what lies beyond our vast universe? The vastness of the cosmos has fascinated humans for centuries, leading scientists to develop incredible technology to uncover its mysteries. And our understanding of the vastness of space has been greatly enhanced by the use of space probes. Voyager 1, which has traveled beyond the Milky Way, is one such probe that has provided vital information and helped advance our knowledge of the universe. And even though it was launched decades ago, Voyager 1 continues to make groundbreaking discoveries, a testament to humanity's unrelenting pursuit of knowledge. Now, recently, Voyager 1 has transmitted a puzzling data set that has left scientists both concerned and a little curious. The possibility of an encounter in interstellar space has NASA scratching their heads, trying to understand the cause of the transmission error. In this video, we'll dive into the details of this intriguing discovery and explore what it could mean for our understanding of the universe. Now, to understand the recent encounter, or glitch, that Voyager 1 is experiencing, it's important to have a comprehensive understanding of the spacecraft's mechanics, its journey, and the environment it currently operates in. So let's start with a quick history lesson. In the late 1970s, NASA's Jet Propulsion System launched the Voyager program with the objective of exploring the planets and environment beyond Mars. The Voyager spacecrafts were specifically designed to withstand the harsh conditions of the giant gas planets, their moons, and the interstellar space beyond our solar system's heliosphere. The engineers at NASA were tasked with creating a spacecraft that could conserve energy, transmit data to Earth, and withstand extreme temperatures, high radiation levels, and even micrometeoroids. At the time, this was an ambitious project, beyond anyone's wildest fantasies, but the engineers worked tirelessly to make it a reality. On September 5th, 1977, NASA launched the groundbreaking Voyager 1 spacecraft into space, followed a few weeks later by Voyager 2 on August 20th. Their primary objective was to study the outer planets, specifically Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, along with their moons. At the time, no other spacecraft had been able to reveal much about the environment and geology of these distant planets. On March 5th, 1979, Voyager 1 successfully reached Jupiter, sending back the first ever data and images of the gas giant and its moons. The images captured by the spacecraft showed intense storms and giant red spot that had been raging for centuries. Scientists were amazed to discover that the red spot, estimated to be around 10,000 miles or 16,000 kilometers in diameter, was actually a huge storm that could engulf Earth entirely. It was located in Jupiter's southern hemisphere, surrounded by high-speed winds that can reach up to 400 miles per hour. In November, the craft ventured further to Saturn's moon, capturing detailed images of Saturn's rings and unveiling new moons like Prometheus and Atlas. It also revealed Saturn's intense storms, including the mammoth Great White Spot, spanning thousands of miles, and shared crucial data on the planet's magnetic field and atmosphere. In December 1980, Voyager 1 concluded its primary mission of studying Jupiter and Saturn. However, the team was then faced with the challenge of propelling the spacecraft towards its next destination, while using minimal fuel. It's worth noting that Voyager 1, like most spacecraft, doesn't rely on traditional fuels such as gasoline or kerosene. Instead, it uses a radioisotope thermoelectric generator, or RTG, to power its instruments and systems. The RTG harnesses the heat produced by the natural decay of plutonium-238 and converts it into electricity using the Seebeck effect, which converts a temperature difference into electrical energy. But even with the use of an RTG, conserving fuel was still necessary for Voyager 1. In a stroke of genius, Michael Manovich, an engineer at JPL NASA, and his team suggested that a planet's gravitational force could alter a spacecraft's trajectory, similar to how it bends the trajectory of a ball thrown towards the ground. By calculating Voyager 1's trajectory, they could determine which planets would be best suited to slingshot the spacecraft towards its next destination. Months of intensive research went into studying the trajectories of the planets, their gravitational fields, and the spacecraft's trajectory to determine the optimal course of action. Ultimately, they decided to utilize the gravity of Saturn to propel Voyager 1 towards Uranus, and then use Uranus's gravity to propel the spacecraft towards Neptune. In the late 1990s, the Voyager 1 probe achieved an astonishing feat that exceeded all expectations. Despite being designed to operate for just 5 years, the spacecraft utilized a fortuitous alignment of outer planets to achieve the necessary velocity to break free from the Sun's gravitational pull. During its flyby of Saturn, Voyager 1 received an unexpected gravitational assist that launched it beyond the plane of our solar system and into the mysterious realm of interstellar space. This vast and uncharted territory lies outside of our solar system and is filled with a sparse mixture of gas, dust, cosmic rays, and enigmatic phenomena yet to be understood. Susan Dodd, NASA's Voyager Mission Project Manager, expressed concerns about the challenges faced by the engineering team due to operating Voyager 1 in an unprecedented high radiation environment in interstellar space. When Voyager 1 entered the unexplored zone beyond the Sun's heliosphere, it posed both incredible scientific opportunities and significant risks. The spacecraft's journey into interstellar space offered a chance to uncover new knowledge about the universe. However, the harsh radiation environment caused by high-energy particles like cosmic rays put the spacecraft's electronic components at risk. Moreover, celestial objects like black holes or gamma ray bursts could impact the data transmitted by the probe and even cause it to lose contact with Earth. Additionally, the spacecraft's trajectory could be affected by the gravity of other celestial bodies, leading to unstable orbits or deviations from its intended path. Over the past 40 years, the Voyager mission has provided invaluable insights into space that were previously unimaginable. This breakthrough has enabled other spacecraft to explore deep space with greater clarity and depth. However, after more than 4 decades of remarkable success in navigating the harshest of environments, Voyager 1 has started returning data that is inexplicable to scientists. This anomaly has left space enthusiasts and scientists baffled. The latest telemetry data from Voyager 1 indicates that the spacecraft has encountered an unknown force in space. Despite being located 14.5 billion miles away from Earth, the probe appears to be functioning normally. However, the spacecraft is unable to determine its location in space, and there's no sign of it entering safe mode. Typically, when a spacecraft's systems detect an anomaly or fault, it automatically enters a safe zone, allowing the mission team to diagnose and resolve any issues. But in this case, the data is defective, and NASA is expecting up to a 21-hour delay in receiving data units from the spacecraft. Now, the Voyager 1 issue is indeed rare and concerning for the team, who are also grappling with the power loss of Voyager 2. To conserve power, the team has disabled non-essential systems, but Voyager 2's functionality is expected to last only until 2025, at the current rate of power loss. Now, after extensive analysis of Voyager 1's data, scientists identified the root cause of the malfunctions as the Altitude Articulation and Control System, or the AACS. And the AACS regulates the spacecraft's orientation and was displaying signs of a glitch, leaving the probe disoriented. However, the discovery did not explain the corrupted telemetry data being transmitted by Voyager 1's systems. Despite these challenges, Voyager 1 continued to transmit data at the expected rate and signal strength, although the information it sent was deemed of no value. Fortunately, the connection was still intact. And despite months of unsuccessful attempts to solve the issue, Voyager 1 unexpectedly started transmitting clear telemetry data one day. NASA's team discovered that a corrupted onboard computer was to blame for the malfunction. The faulty computer had been corrupting data for months, confusing the team's attempts to restore the spacecraft's functionality. Now, some scientists speculate that Voyager 1's extended exposure to interstellar radiation and cosmic particles could have triggered the malfunction. And although the issue was ultimately resolved in time, it remains unclear how much longer the Voyager missions can continue transmitting valuable data before becoming lost in space. And furthermore, what new spacecraft will take its place if Voyager ever ceases to function? The tale of Voyager 1's encounter reminds us of the immense mysteries that await us in the vast expanse of space. It underscores the risks inherent in our pursuit of knowledge and exploration, but also highlights the importance of expanding the boundaries of our understanding and venturing into new frontiers. The Voyager 1 mission serves as a testament to human courage and determination in the face of the unknown, inspiring us to continue pushing the limits of what is possible and to keep reaching for the stars.